Good morning. In this video, we are going to see about role of government in agricultural marketing. What are the steps or what are the institutions or what are the ways government has created for marketing an agricultural commodity in a better way or in a satisfactory way for both the farmer and also for a consumer. So first, regulated markets. So these regulated markets are mainly introduced for making rules and regulations. So in markets there must be some rules and regulations to make the process of agricultural marketing in an orderly manner. First, these regulated markets are not a compulsory market for the farmers. The farmers who are willing to sell their products in these markets are welcomed to sell their products, but it is not a compulsory one that the farmers must sell their produce in the regulated markets. Next, in this market is mainly established by government to eliminate the malpractices in the system and to assign the dominating powers to the farmers in the market. So the producers or farmers who brought their produce would be in dominating position to fix their prices or to bargain for prices. There should not be any malpractices in this market. Next, in traditional market there are many malpractices or many problems faced by the producer or farmer. Likewise, high marketing cost, unauthorized deductions of marketing charges, various malpractices like malpractices in weighing or grading like that. So these are to be eliminated to make a market should be in an efficient manner. Next, this more or less removed by exercising the public control like regulated markets. That means while introducing regulated markets with some rules and regulation, these malpractices has been removed or it has been reduced to a lower level. First, establishment of this regulated markets is not an alternative way of marketing, but it is an efficient, it created for making conditions to be, to make that performance of a market to be efficient for both the producer and consumer. So next, farmers can sell their produce in a regulated markets through open bidding or open auction method. So there will be more competitive bidding while the farmers directly selling their produce to the ultimate consumer or the end consumer, end users. Next, main objectives of establishing this regulated markets are, first one, to prevent the exploitation of farmers. Farmers are to be protected from over exploitation of prices. Next, to make an effective and efficient marketing system for the farmers. So while making an efficient system for farmers may sell their produce directly to a consumer at reasonable prices. Next, to make orderly marketing of an agriculture produce. Next, important features of this regulated markets are, under this Agricultural Produce Market Act, government can bring any area. I mean, they can sell, notify any area that it is a market area or market yard or main assembling point or sub-market yard like that. So these are to be notified or notified, and it has been taken under regulation by the government to make the proper movement of the produce from producer to consumer. Next, the produce may be sold either open auction method or maybe in closed auction method. Licensed weighman will be there for selling their produce, but sales of produce will be taken only after the grading of that particular produce. Next, market news services will be available for both producer and consumer, so the prices will be informed to the producer so they can sell their produce for the particular price that is prevailing in the market. Next, supervisions. So the staffs and the secretary or auction clerk will be there for supervising this overall marketing activities. Next step is cooperative markets. So these cooperative markets are introduced to make a collective marketing of the produce. So produce produced by the farmers or producers to be collected by a man collectively by them, and they are going to sell their produce in the market. So in this individual farmer can enjoy the benefit or advantage of a large scale business. So while marketing their produce in a bulk or in a huge quantity, they can experience a minimum cost and a maximum profit. So which it is not possible for an individual producer while their individual marketing surplus is very small. So this cooperative marketing is a voluntary business organization. There is no compulsion for farmers to join in this. In a voluntary basis, they can join and they can collect the produce produced by them, and they can sell their produce directly to the consumer. So functions of this produce is to market the farm produce at fair prices. So to market the farm produce at fair prices means while dealing in bulk quantities, they can sell at fair prices. Next, to prevent the members from excessive cost. So while they are marketing or they are selling their produce in an individual person or in person, means they will get a lot of costs like transportation cost, loading, unloading cost, grading cost, like that. So while they are selling in a cooperative manner or they are selling in a collective form, means it will be reduced. Next, to avail credit facility. So while making this produce as a security, they can avail credit facility by moving through cooperative markets. Next, through cooperative markets, the farmers are arranged for the supply of inputs, transport, storage, and export facilities. So they can sell their produce or they can avail inputs whenever they are in need of it. Next, structures of cooperative marketing. So one is two-tier system. And two-tier system, state level marketing federation will be there. Under this, primary cooperative marketing societies will be there at taluk level. So under three-tier system, first state level marketing federation will be there, and then district market societies will be there, and last primary cooperative marketing societies will be there. So while comparing two-tier and three-tier, in two-tier there will be only two stages. First one is state level, next is taluk level. But in three-tier system, in center of in middle of state and taluk, district marketing societies will be active. Okay, this two-tier system is found except in Assam, Bihar, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Orissa, Rajasthan, and West Bengal. So except these states, all other states are following this two-tier system. This three-tier system is followed in Assam, Bihar, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Orissa, and Rajasthan, West Bengal. So advantages of cooperative marketing. First one is increasing bargaining power of that farmers or producer. Next, direct dealing with the final buyers. So there won't be any intermediaries or middlemen in this. There, provision of credit. Next, easier and cheaper transport, storage facilities. So these are the advantages. Also, grading and sanitation facilities will be available for the whole produce. Next, market intelligence or market news will be available. Influence of influencing market price. This influencing market price means while they are dealing in a huge quantity or large bulk quantities, means they can influence the market price because they are dealing, they have a large supply. They have a huge supply of that particular produce, so they can influence the market price. Next, provision of inputs by this cooperative marketing. Next. Next one is a farmers market, commonly known as or popularly known as Ulava Sandai. So this is to eliminate middlemen for both farmers and consumers. Those middlemen are exploiting both farmers and consumers. So to eliminate them, this Ulava Sandai has been established. It is established, introduced in 1999. So a process of middlemen is from farmer, they are getting produce at a low price. So while getting buying a produce to low price, and also they are getting a commission from the farmers. So this middleman, after getting their produce from farmer, they will sell it to retail businessmen. So from farmer, they will, while they are getting at low prices, to they will sell to retail businessmen in a higher prices or higher rates. So again, these retail businessmen will sell to the consumers in a more higher rate. So At last, while we see in this process of middlemen involving in agricultural marketing, price received by the producer is very low and the price reduced by the consumer is very high. In between, the total profit is gained by this middleman. So in order to eliminate this middleman gaining more profit from the produce by the farmer and who is going to use it at a consumer, this ulavasandhai has been established. So hence government introduced ulavasandhai. Its aim is to make direct contact between the farmers and public, or the farmers and the consumer. Next, to provide fresh vegetables and fruits. While in the process of middlemen, they will sell storage goods or stored goods, they will buy and store or speculation, they can involve in speculating or hedging the product to increase the price of the product. But while we are dealing with ulavasandhai means, or while dealing farmers market means, they will directly sell the fresh vegetables at a reasonable prices to the consumers. Next point is, it gives full satisfaction to the farmers and also for the public or the consumers. So while selling their produce directly, they can get maximum profit, and also it is a very satisfaction for public to get a less price than the retail stores. Next, in farmers market, the price will be higher than that of a wholesale price. While a farmer is selling their produce to a wholesaler or a middleman at a lower price, same produce will be sold in a farmers market at higher prices than the wholesale prices. Next, it also acts as a technical training center for farmers who are in needs of some training, or in some training like grading or weighing, like that they are giving training for also. Next, silent features means, first one, the prices that are that prevail in farmers market is 20% higher than the wholesale price and 15% less than that of retail prices. So for a producer, while 20% more than the wholesale price is given for his produce, he will be happy, or he will be voluntarily selling their produce in the farmers market. For and in respect to consumer, in the view of consumer, while the product is given to him 15% less than the price of a retail price, he will be happy to buy their produce from the farmers market. Next, the prices of the produce are displayed in front of the shops. So there won't be any deviation in the prices. So each before every shops, prices of the particular produce that is sold in the shop will be displayed. Next, rent-free shops for the farmers. Farmers who are selling their produce in regulated markets are given that shop at a rent-free basis, and they can sell, they can store their produce, they can keep their produce until the produce are sold. Next, no luggage fares for the goods carried. So while a farmer producing their produce and transporting it to his production point to the market, there is no luggage fare while he is taking for ulavasandhai or farmers market. Next, weighing scales are provided freely at the market. So the weighing machine is given at a free of cost for every farmer who is selling their produce in farmers market. Next, this farmers market works for all the 7 days, and storage facilities are also available to store the remaining unsold produce. So these are the initiatives that has been taken by government to regulate or to improve the marketing of agricultural produce. Thank you.